bicycles are getting more and more popularity nowadays, especially in the southern part of the countries in Bangalore and Chennai, because companies are making their way of building brand new ecosystems throughout the country. While there are brands like Tesla and Rivian making their own electric vehicles in the West, there are some indigenous Indian companies which make their electric vehicles in India, and there are some Korean also and some Japanese companies which provide some really good electric vehicles for the price in India. So I have made a list of top electric vehicles you can buy or at least consider buying in India. This list is not going to be in the order of worst to best or best to worst. It's just a random list which I have made. So without any delay, let's get started. The first one in the list is Tata Electric. Tata had previously made electric cars, not like they're making electric cars now, but the previous electric cars were all low-powered vehicles which no one were actually buying much. But this time Tata has taken it to the next level. They introduced their Nexon EV in 2019, which absolutely blew everyone's mind. I would say Tata nailed this car. Everything from the 0 to 60 time to the blue body color and the whine of the motors, everything was perfectly done well, and for the first time ever in India, people are genuinely considering buying this car. It looked and felt nothing much different than its petrol counterpart Nexon. Even though the whole powertrain under the hood was electric, this car is equipped with 30.2 kilowatt hour battery pack, and the motor is a 129 horsepower permanent magnet electric motor which gives out almost 245 newton meters of torque. And also the top speed goes all the way up to 120 kilometers per hour, which is not great. And guess the range, it is almost 312 kilometers, which is certified by ARAI, but the true range will almost come up to 250 to 300. Only the driving patterns will tell that, but you can actually consider taking this car for long rides though, which is not really happening with electric cars nowadays. But this car can give you a range of 250 to 300 kilometers. That is really, really great. The interiors are very similar to the petrol counterpart Nexon, of course, except a gear shifter, because obviously in electric you can't get a gear shifter, you can't get transmission there, it runs on a single transmission. And I like the way that they have put in this blue themed color all over the car, which runs really smooth, and I think it really makes sense to put these kind of futuristic look to electric cars now. The second one on the list is Mahindra Electric. Now everyone has heard of this car called Reva, the tiny, mini, cute, compact car which was on the road. Even though there were not many Revas on the roads, people still kinda accepted it very well in India. Now there is the E2O Plus, which you can consider buying if you require a compact sized, mini, low powered commute car which is almost free to drive every day. Well, you might think that as it is a low powered car, you might miss on some major features which you might have taken for granted before, but no, this car tries to get everything with it, like a digital gauge cluster, a good infotainment system with all the Android Auto or Apple CarPlay features, and also a reverse parking camera and all that other good stuff. Has a 210 ampere hour battery pack with a 30 kilowatt motor which produces almost 91 newton meters of torque, which is not bad at all, and the range will go up to 140 kilometers, which is pretty good for city commute. That means you'll be zipping around city streets with its small size and some good amount of torque available instantly. The next one on the list is Hyundai Kona Electric. This is one interesting, stylish looking electric SUV which can be a potential buying option, just like the Tata Nexon EV. Has some futuristic accents everywhere, varying from the wheels to the grills. And also this is the only electric SUV in India which kind of looks huge comparatively and actually looks like an SUV rather than a crossover. Apparently the Kona EVs in the West are more powerful, and of course they are more expensive cars for some obvious reasons. Here in India, no one would buy a damn expensive electric SUV. So yeah, that's the case. Talking about the spec sheet, this car comes with a 39.2 kilowatt hour battery pack with a permanent magnet motor which gives out almost 136 horsepower with 395 newton meters of torque. And guess the range, it is almost 452 kilometers. The torque numbers and the range numbers are one of the highest in this list. But in real life, I don't think the range will even reach about 400 kilometers. Yeah, it's kind of a bummer, but this is not really a bad electric car. It is really a better electric car than the Nexon EV, and of course for the higher starting price. The next one on the list is the MG ZS EV. This is an electric SUV crossover, both I guess. It's a very new brand in India which has already made its name with the MG Hector, which is their petrol and diesel SUVs. They've taken the same body language and added a torquey electric powertrain to it, and you have a pretty good performing electric vehicle. This car actually competes very well with the Kona Electric, as both are marketed as electric SUVs. And also, talking about the spec sheet, this car has a battery pack of 44.5 kilowatt hours, and the electric motor gives out almost 143 horsepower. And also, guess the torque, it is almost 350 newton meters. And the range, this car can go up to a range of 340 kilometers for a single charge, which is pretty good considering it's an SUV. In fact, this is more powerful than the Kona Electric on paper. I'm really amazed to see how similar these electric cars and the normal IC cars look when you park them side by side, which really makes sense because you don't want to make electric cars a novelty. You want to normalize EVs in the Indian automobiles market. Both Kona and the MG are very similar cars when it comes to their performances, but the MG looks a bit more powerful on paper. Ultimately, the choice is left to the customer. So the next one on the list is Ather Energy. Oh boy, I pretty much feel that the 450 and the 450X doesn't need any introduction, as these scooters have pretty much become the trend in the EV industry, at least in India. There are two videos which I have made on these two scooters on my channel alone, so you can just think of how many videos are floating around YouTube every day regarding these two scooters. I'll tell you what Ather did right here. A pricey scooter, yeah, but did they compromise anything on the performance? A big fat no. They provided you a best-in-class software and a best-in-class hardware and a freaking internet connection on a two-wheeler city scooter. In my personal experience, even I haven't fully discovered what this thing can do. The 450 comes with a BLDC motor which can give you a power output of 5.4 kilowatts and a torque output of 20.5 newton meters, a 2.4 kilowatt hour lithium ion battery, and this scooter can top up to 80 kilometers per hour according to Ather. And also it gives a range all the way from 55 kilometers to 75 kilometers per charge. The 450X, a slightly better scooter with a peak power output of 6 kilowatts, and the range has been increased from 75 to 85 kilometers, and also the torque numbers have been increased from 20.5 newton meters to 26 newton meters. Both of them come with a 7-inch touchscreen displays. The 450 comes with a Linux-based operating system which lacks the Bluetooth features, but the 450X comes with an Android-based operating system which has the Bluetooth features, so that's a significant difference when it comes to the dashboards of the scooters. Trust me, these Ather scooters have made a lot of noise in the Indian EV industry. At least in Bangalore and Chennai, I see a lot of scooters zipping around the cities. And if you want more information or a complete picture of what these scooters can do, you can watch two of my videos based on these scooters. So yeah, that's my coverage on the Ather 450 and the 450X.
So the last one on the list is Okinawa. See, I wouldn't lie, Okinawa scooters are making quite a noise nowadays in the EV industry of India. They even have the potential to compete with the Ather scooters. The scooters like the iPrace Plus are really becoming a trend nowadays. This is also a smart scooter which comes with its own mobile app like the Ather's, but I wouldn't say that these are that sophisticated like the Ather scooters with proper proprietary software. So the iPrace Plus can reach a range of 130 plus kilometers per charge, and this runs on a 1 kilowatt BLDC motor. That is kinda less, I would say, when it comes to power output. And the battery which this scooter has is a 3.3 kilowatt hour lithium ion battery, which is actually detachable, by the way. You can take it and charge it outside the scooter. And also this scooter tops up to 58 kilometers per hour. Well, here I wouldn't recommend their lower powered models, as they just don't keep up with the performance which are similar to the conventional petrol scooters. So don't go for the lower end models. If you want to buy an Okinawa scooter, consider buying their iPrace or iPrace Plus. The best thing about this scooter is it gives you a range of 100 plus kilometers per charge. Of course, for a little lesser power, but if you are one who only cares about the distance of your commute and not much of a power or torque fans, you can easily choose this scooter for your daily commute, as this can give you some decent levels of performance for a higher range per charge. And the most important part, I'll put the price of each and every electric vehicle I mentioned here right now. So this brings us to the end of the video. If you feel that I have missed any electric vehicle in this list, you can put them in the comment section below. I'll definitely have a look. And if you like the overall video, do leave a like. If you're new to the channel, do subscribe to my channel. And as always, this is Pawan signing out.